Yo, what is going on, everyone, and welcome back to another video. My name is Levi. Today's video, I'm going to
today, Junior!
Today's video, I'm going to take you guys through a day in the life on how I manage basically everything that I currently do. Right now, it's around 5:40 a.m. after finally getting my clothes on and everything. It takes me a little while. I also eat a banana before I'm about to do what I'm about to do, which is go for a run. Lately, I've been trying to go for runs in the morning just because like I was still like wanting to get my runs in after training for the Spartan race, but I was kind of tired of training at night after our workouts just because I was so tired. So we're gonna go for a run, but it is currently pitch black out. Not only that, but it is also like freezing out. I think it's about 34 degrees right now. We're waiting for our GPS still, which is taking forever. You guys are wondering what watch I use. It's the Garmin 4Runner 55. Got our shoes on, all birds. I would record this run, but you guys wouldn't see anything on the GoPro because it's pitch black. Plus, my GoPro still doesn't work, but I'll see you guys back for breakfast in about 22, maybe 25 minutes. I'm going for a 3-miler today, so yeah, all you guys know how it goes. Old beanies coming 2023. Motherfucker. Woo! Alright, so ends up turning out. I don't even know what that means. Watch is dead. Like, star button, nothing's coming on. We'll see what the time is when we go inside. I'll let you guys know. It was 5:55 as soon as I took off, so hopefully we get somewhere in like the 6:18 range for like a good 3-mile pace, but I'm gonna go in, get some breakfast. I'm gonna say grubbing, but I gotta get cooking first. Just some protes, eggs, and an apple for breakfast. This isn't a full day eating, so I'm not going to go over exactly everything I'm eating, but when I came in, it was 6:18, so that means we finished in about 23 minutes, and it may have been a little more than 3 miles. I'm not too sure. I'm just trying to give myself the better benefit of the doubt to just, I don't know, maybe make myself feel better. Just may go up in the shower, may get dressed for the day. I'm going to read 10 pages of Endure right now because that's the book I'm on by Cameron Haynes, and that's a really good book so far. I'd really suggest you read it if you're into like any self-help books or if you're into just motivation, whatever it might be, working out, running. Definitely a must read. And oh, today is the 6th, so that means David Goggins' book comes out. I just pre-ordered that, so it'll be shipping here today. For the do, I'm gonna go get ready for the rest of the day.
Okay.
I don't even know what that was. I just feel so relaxed after that run. Like every time I go for a run just to like start my day, I just feel so chiller thriller throughout the rest of the day. And so that's where I'm at like mentally right now. But I'm about to jump into the Word of God right now and just get into devotion, and then also write in a gratitude journal what I'm thankful for today, what I'm grateful for. So I get into the Word every single morning. Like this is my time to get into the Word. I usually have like a little more time than I do this morning to get into the Word, but I was just running late on a couple things, but still I'm still going to get into it just to start my day right. I usually do this just for about like 10-15 minutes, maybe a little less than that sometimes. Like today it'll probably be a little less. And then I get on into school for classes and whatnot. If you guys are wondering what devotion I'm reading, it's called Jesus Calling by Sarah Young. It's pretty good, man. It's pretty good. It can be kind of repetitive at times, but it's still good. I'm gonna get working on this, and we're gonna head on in to finish up some classes, accounting to be specific. the worst class of them all. It's almost the end of the quarter, so I've just been focused on getting prepared for finals, just been studying a lot. I usually spend, this is just on average either way, if I don't have finals or if I do have finals, I'm usually here from 7:30 in the morning when the doors open all the way until like 12:20 when my last class ends. And between that time, I'm just spending a majority of my time like studying, getting my schoolwork out of the way so I can spend the rest of my day towards something like, I don't know, more fun, I guess. Which is like editing or other things that you guys are going to see throughout the day. So most of my day is spent at school just studying, which is pretty boring and you guys don't want to see that. So here's maybe like my campus,
downtown Tacoma.
So Rory called me. Let's see what he's up to.
Oh, did I answer this?
Rory.
Oh, we're on the phone with him for a minute.
You guys really care, but the classes I took this quarter were accounting, business, law, and economics. Business law has by far been my most favorite class just because it's one that's actually interesting. Man, it is cold out, dude. Not like the cold at all. Now, some of you guys are probably wondering what major I'm in. I'm in business management. The reason I chose that is just because it's so similar to what I do on here. I would just say like I definitely lack like management skills. Some of you guys know I dropped out. Wait, I was in college. I dropped out of college. So I went back to college. I only have a year of college, so that's why I went back and I was like, okay, I've paid this much money. I might as well just get the piece of paper out of it and just call it a day. You know? So yeah, I don't know. We'll see. Maybe it'll actually lead to something, but if not, I don't really care. I was studying kinesiology at first, but it was just not as fun as I thought. I thought like, oh, I like working out, I like fitness and stuff, so I thought I would end up liking the whole concept of it, but I actually hate it. I hated it. Like, if you guys have ever studied anatomy and physiology, that's a tough subject. That's about 12:20 now. I usually get home in about like 20 minutes from now, so I'll be home around 12:40, make some lunch, and find out what there is to do on the to-do list. Man, I deserve this cup of coffee. I actually forgot one of my books back at school, so I had to drive all the way 20 minutes back to school and drive all the way 20 minutes back after already going to school and coming back and then going back again. So yeah, this coffee was well earned. So usually I get home at around, like I said, 12:40. I eat dinner and then I also start making content, posting my content. So I got my Instagram post up for today. I got a TikTok up for today. And now it's time to go work on my YouTube editing and whatnot. So this time after I get home with school is basically like, okay, go to work. Like, it's time to go do my job, which is creating content and inspiring people and whatnot. So that's exactly what I do, but I usually like don't do it down here. Whoa, you guys are kind of like low, but yeah, so like I said, I don't do it obviously down in the kitchen, I do it up here. I get all my editing done with, I just kind of get in the rhythm of doing the duo. I've gotten a lot better at editing. It's funny looking back at some of like my oldest videos and just seeing how far I've come. But editing is like a very long process. I would like to have an editor one day, but at the same time, it's kind of hard to have an editor when like the style of my editing. I don't know. Let me know if you guys like my editing, because if you don't, maybe I'll hire someone. I don't know. That would kind of be embarrassing. But at the same time, I don't care if it's embarrassing. I need to get better. So if someone editing it, we'll make it better for you guys. Please let me know. From that rant though, but yeah, I'll go all the way from about, I usually get started at like 1:40 and then I'll go all the way to about 3:45 and then that's when I'll have lunch. I just need this time to really hone in on the content and just get it out of the way. So for our pre-workout stack today, we are going to be having some creatine. Creatine doesn't really do too much, if anything, before your workout. People usually recommend it to have it after your workout, which I also recommend. And then we're also going to be having some pump product for our pre-workout. And this is actually going to do something for our lift. It's essentially just going to allow more blood flow into the muscle, which is going to essentially give us more of a pump. It also has pink Himalayan salt, and as some of you guys know, sodium does help with a pump in the gym. Some of you guys know on this channel, I don't really take caffeinated like pre-workouts, and the reason being for that is just because my heart feels like it's going to explode every single time I have over more than like 150 milligrams of caffeine, probably from the constant 300 milligrams every single morning for like over a year usage. But hey, we're still able to have pre-workout just stimulated free. But today we're gonna be doing deadlifts for the first time in forever. I'm a little nervous about it because I don't know where I'm at. I'm kind of scared, like just nervous to see how much weight I can pull. Bubba's picking us up today, and I'll normally take this about like 20 minutes before the gym, 15, 20 minutes. No, I would say sooner than that, because then if I take it too sooner, then the effects are gonna wear off too early. And then if I take it too late, then I'm gonna have a full stomach of like water and fluid in my stomach, and I don't like to feel like I'm gonna throw up during my workout. Thinking about doing a powerlifting meet again. We're doing like a more so power building sort of like workout routine. I was gonna be here any second. Bean, shut up, no one's talking to you. Shh. Shh. Hey. Stop. Feisty pug.
What's up, YouTube people? Hey, what's going on?
Hey, come on.
Come on.
Some of you guys, I feel like I never properly introduced Bubba. This is Bubba.
I am Bubba.
Yeah, this has been a lifelong friend of mine for, I don't know, dude, more years than some like, of you guys have been alive.
Probably like 15 years, I don't know.
15 years. How old are we?
Seven. Something like that, probably.
Yeah, somewhere around there. So we've been friends for a while. We've been working out for like the past 3 months. He also trained for the Spartan race we never even got to do, but we're about to get in. I'm gonna slam this pre-workout. Are you doing deadlifts today?
What
are you doing deadlifts today?
Yeah, I'll join you today.
Okay, yeah. Go light. I forgot my belt.
All right.
Yeah, but yeah, that means we're gonna go light today. They do have like a belt in there. I'll probably use it just so I can like do some sort of like actual weight to get back into the rhythm of everything. I also wore flat shoes for deadlift just because I hate wearing tennis shoes deadlifting. It feels awkward. It feels like I'm like flimsy a little bit, but I think that's just in my head. Yeah, we're gonna get in there and hit the folks. So for every deadlift session, it's gonna be following the same principle I've been doing for like all my other strength, I would say training regimens. So for bench, as you guys know, I'm following a very similar style like this, which we're gonna do today for deadlift. And so what we're gonna be doing is the first set, we're gonna be going for a rep range of 8 to 10, increase the weight, then go for a rep range of 6 to 8, then increase the rep range and go from 4 to 6, and then 2 to 4, and so on. And every week, if I get stronger, let's just say in like the 8 to 10 rep range, I'm gonna try to increase the weight while also still trying to hit the 8 to 10 rep range. So that's what we're doing today. 315, this is where I left off. I haven't deadlifted in over 6 months now. So, see where we're at. They want to know.
January.
January?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. December.
December?
February? Next year.
Next year. There we go. That's the right answer. Yeah, so those shirts are coming out next year along with the stringers. I don't have everything. There's like this tab right here too. We got the size. Sorry, Bubba. Size and everything on the inside. Last time it just said size. Gray. This is the only color we have right now.
Yep.
It's pretty cool. I'll probably do black and then
white. If you can get it to work well, the white.
White.
Yeah.
I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. I'm like asking people in here as if they're like doctors. I'm like, yeah, it's like right here, you know? And someone was like, yeah, it's like where your tricep is. And I'm like, oh yeah, you're right. No way. Oh, I don't know what happened. It hurts, like just extending it. I think I just hyperextended it when I dropped the weight on my hammer curl. So I think it's just hyperextended a little bit. Go home, put some ice on it. It's around 7:15 right now, a little later than we want, but it's actually earlier, surprisingly, than the times we've been leaving. So that's actually great. Plus we did deadlifts today and running a new program. And every time we run a new program, it just takes a little longer. So gonna go home, get some dinner down, and then we're gonna go work on Kill Bill. And somehow we have magically changed into the scenery of my room. It is a little later. I got home at around 7:35, 7:40, ate some dinner. As soon as I'm done with dinner, I usually come back up here and I start working on my business. Some of you guys know I have a clothing brand that's dropping in the new year. Kind of talked about it in the gym and whatnot, but I give myself about 45 minutes to work on that. Some days I'm like coming up with designs. Some days I'm just talking to people, manufacturers, trying to get like the clothing just right, or I'm reviewing a sample. Just kind of depends on what I have scheduled for that day to work on with the clothing brand. I also iced out my elbow today just because of how bad I just hyperextended it today. We were like taking pictures and I was like doing like a bicep curl thinking I was like dope, the picture will be on the screen. And I went down and it was like, and I was like, and so it's just been hurting like crazy. So I iced out for a little while. But yeah, I've just been working on this Shopify thing here. I'm going to put you guys in like the bottom left corner, or I'm going to put me in the bottom left corner and show you guys my screen just to show you guys what we're working with. So right now, if you go to killbuilt.com, which I own, it doesn't exist. And that's because I've bought it, but I haven't even published the website yet. I literally just own the URL, so that's where I'm at, and that's my homework. I'm just in the midst of building that right now. It's almost 9:30. Typically try to aim to go to bed between 9-10 o'clock at night. I like to get my sleep. Once it's like past 8:30, dude, I'm ready. Like, I'm ready to start getting to bed, or I'm ready to just slow things down a lot for the day. Before I end this video, I know in the beginning of the video I said like I try to get into the Word end of the morning, and also before I go to bed, I usually do this on my phone with the Bible app. It's called like YouVersion, but I will get in the Word. I just have my Bible here for reference in terms of getting in the Word. I'll get in the Word again before I go to bed. I'll just do one of the Bible plans just to, I don't know, have the last thing that I hear during the day be God's Word. Like, I want like the first thing that I do in the morning, even though it's not like the first exact thing that I do, but I want the last thing that I hear before I go to bed is God's Word. Just helps to calm me, helps me relax me, helps to remember who's in control. And yeah, hopefully maybe some of you guys out there are looking to get into, I don't know, knowing Jesus a little more. Maybe you can start by doing something like I do before I go into bed. But that's going to do it for this video. I hope you guys like this day in the life. I thought it was pretty fun. I liked recording it, but let me know what you guys think. Without being said, I will see you guys in the next one. Before I do, die trying to do what you love. The sky is the limit. And I can't remember if I said what am I saying? I can't remember if I said subscribe to me or not. We're getting way too complicated with this ending. I'll see you guys in the next one.